Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. If you have a guys Ford Fiesta generation 2008-2017, the MK7, MK7.5, this specifically is an ST, but it will be the same procedure for regular Fiesta. And you start the car or turn the ignition on, we'll have that annoying clicking sound now. Okay, sometimes it goes away, sometimes it not. Okay, this one right here, or if you mess with the heater. But pretty much every time you start the car, it makes that clicking sound. Annoying, really annoying. So, what's causing that now? Okay, let us explain you quick and show you how to fix it for really cheap. And you can find the parts and tools we use in the description of the video below. Now, this is the blend door actuator causing that clicking sound. This is the blend door actuator. It's very, very inexpensive. It's not too complicated to replace, so we're going to go ahead and show you how to do it in today's video. As a reminder guys, we'll have more than 200 videos on this Ford Fiesta, taking anything you can think of apart, doing mechanical work, timing belts, all that stuff. We took the whole interior apart, so if you need anything, videos will be uploaded all the time. So please subscribe, and if you need help with anything specific, drop a comment, we'll try to make a video. So, where is that actuator, blend door actuator located? We removed that plastic piece and it's nowhere here. You can see, I can see the shifter cables here, ABS, the airbag module, my bad. This is the condenser, okay, right here, I mean the AC part. And this is where the blower motor is on the other side. Now, how you access that thing? You can access it through the steering wheel column right here. We need to turn the steering wheel a little bit to the left, okay, and there is one screw that we'll need to remove. This one there. Now you have to be careful not to scratch anything, so take your time, gently remove the screw, and there will be the same screw, okay, on the other side. So let's turn the steering wheel. Same screw like this one on the other side. We'll remove it as well. After that, there is one more bolt that we need to remove. Okay, the bolt is underneath. Okay, it's all the way right here. Okay. You can see right there. So we need to make sure that you catch it with the socket, with the same Torx that we're using. Okay, Torx 25. All the parts and tools again will be listed in the description of the video below for your convenience. Perfect. Now, you grab this piece right here gently. Okay, and you need to start separating it. On each side there is a few clips. Okay, like that. Now the top piece, okay, will stay there, that's fine, we don't need it. Now we'll need to go ahead and remove the bottom piece as well. And you can see it has two holders here and one on the other side. Okay, and some people said that you might have screws. If you have screws here on that specific model, there is no screws. Okay, we'll have a video how to remove the airbag and how to get to it. Okay, pull that plastic all the way out. Now, what you want to do, pull the steering wheel all the way out and up as much as it can go. Then lock it in place. Okay, just pull the handle up like that and I'll show you where the actuator now is located. Okay, so now with the plastic removed, that right here, that's your actuator. He has only three bolts holding it in place. And it's a little bit hard to remove them, okay, but it's doable. So we'll go ahead, start on it now and show you how we can achieve that. If you need to, you can move the cable a little bit so we can get to it a little bit better, but careful not to damage anything. So I just realized there is only two screws, not three, my bad. So we'll start removing them. You can see the one on top right here and the other one is towards the bottom. So we'll be using a Torx 20. This is the star looking bit. I'll recommend getting the one with the socket attached to it so it cannot slip out, because otherwise if you drop it, you're done. And you might have that rattling socket behind the dash, so we'll recommend using that one. You can find it in the description of the video below. So now, Okay, you can see the top bolt is right here. Okay, my bad. Okay, and I'll just go ahead, take it off. Usually once you get those loose, they go by hand pretty easy. Okay, so I just removed one of them, the bottom one, all the way. You can see what it looks like, small screw. Now the one on top is loose all the way as well. I just need to pull it out. Okay, like that. Now we need to pull it out and we need to disconnect the wiring harness to see how we're going to do that now. Okay, the motor came out, but the wire is short. Okay, this is the wiring harness. Now that red thing needs to go up. Okay. It needs to be open all the way up. And then you will press down and disconnect the wire. And this is the little motor out of here. Now, let me see if I can bring the wire up a little bit so I can show you a little bit better. Okay, where the notch is. But in my case, okay, this is the red thing, and right in front of the red thing there is a black place where you press down and you pull it out. It's really hard to show it now. Now you can see that this new one, actually, and the old one as well, they have one tooth less. There is one white space. Now you can actually see it on the gear there. Okay, that white space. Okay, that's the gear there. And if you need to adjust it, you can see that white gear on the side. That's where my finger is. Okay, if you turn it, if you turn that white gear, the top gear will turn as well. Okay, now that's all the way, like that. And you can align it so you can install the new blind door actuator. Okay, and before we install the new one, let's take the old one apart quick, just to see what goes wrong in those things, those little things. It has to be something small, like a plastic gear broken, or something like that, that will cause it to skip, and it will make that ticking, clicking sound. Okay, came out, so first impression, everything looks fine here, so let's go ahead and start disassembling. Pull that gear out. Okay, the first thing that we see, one tooth missing from that gear. So that's the only problem. You can see one tooth missing, and when it comes to that point, it starts skipping. As a result, you hear that clicking sound. So you can see that's the problem. Now, I have the new one already. I just connect the wire. Now, you need to make sure that it goes in the teeth there. And if it doesn't, you have to turn the gear a little bit. So ours is all the way in. All I have to do next, guys, just install the two screws. So I got the bolts tightened. Before we actually put everything together, I want to test it first. Now I want to make sure that it's blowing here. Okay. Check all the settings on the heater. Everything's good. Flip it in the feed. No noise, hot, cold. I'm going to do all that stuff just to make sure that there is no noise. I'll turn all of them off. That's when you usually mix it, so everything's great. That's how we fix it, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, many more videos to come, and see you next time.